Tonight is a very special night. I arrived home from work today and saw this parcel waiting for me. In this parcel is the replacement second drill that I ordered all the way from the UK. Let's see what's inside. Just before we jump into this, we'll see what's in the box. I woke up in the wee hours this morning and started to work on my shaping the wheelchair and bridge before I had to go to work. I love receiving parcels from cousins. I don't know why. I have no affiliation with cousins, but I find a lot of their stuff that they sell is the best price out there. And when I was getting into watchmaking, they had the best online shop that I found. And it was so easy to use, and they just seemed to be leaps and bounds ahead of all their competition. So it gave me the opportunity to purchase these watchmaking tools that could let me pursue my passion and what I want to do. And so, yeah, I have a real affinity for Cousins UK. Shout out to Cousins UK. If you want to give a discount code for the viewers, that'd be much appreciated. So I probably did buy more than I needed to, but I was talking to someone by the name Oliver, and his Instagram handle is OBR_horology. He's a watchmaker. He works full time as a watchmaker. He's doing some really cool guilloche work and doing silversmithing, learning about enameling. I'm sure we're all going to see some amazing work from him very soon. Another thing I ordered that I'm very excited to receive, which is why I brought Oliver up in the first place, is that we were talking about decorations, and you know, I've seen so many videos, especially like the master independent watchmakers, Philippe Dufour, you know, Kari Vuutilainen, and or really high-end watch manufacturers, and you see them using this timber with a paste, doing their final polish on the bevels. And I asked Oliver if he knew, because he has experience, because he's gone overseas and spent time in several very prominent watchmakers' workshops. And he said the name, which is Gentian, or Gentian. So I can barely speak one language, which is English, so cut me a bit of slack. I'm really bad with pronunciations. But so I looked it up, and lo and behold, Cousins st- stock it now. I don't know when they started stocking it, but they didn't stock it before. And this is it here. So this is a special tree that grows in Switzerland, apparently only. And during spring or autumn, the branches fall and they collect them. And it's hollow inside, they break them. And they use this timber with some polishing paste to give the final polish on, say, like the classic Philippe Dufour bevels that I love and so many people love, and I really aspire to achieve something similar. And I saw so many videos of you know, people using this timber, and you know, I always wanted to get my hands on some, and now I have it, and I'm definitely going to use it. So I'm looking forward to that. Now it's time to get back into what this package is all about, and that is the second wheel jewel. First things first is I need to measure the thickness or the height. I call it the height. Some people call it the thickness of the jewel, to make sure that it's the same as the other one or very close. Just as long as it's not like half the thickness. I think that will be a bit bad for the depthing. But yeah. So it is the same thickness, which is a good thing. And as you can see, it's 2.3 millimeters. So the 229 reamer will be perfect for this jewel. That looks a lot better. Look, there it is. I forgot to countersink the jewel hole. Now I'm going to have to push it out. But that was a real snug fit. Those new reamers that I bought, they're so good. Now I'm going to get what's called the pump pusher. It has a spring-loaded pump center, and that allows you to align the hole directly. And it feels like the pinion and the barrel have really good engagement together. So I'm very happy. Now it's time to put the train wheels with the train bridge and see how the engagement between the second wheel and the third wheel in, pinion is. So I am extremely happy with the results so far. I mean, I can't complain at all. I'm extremely, extremely happy. Nothing major catastrophe has happened as yet. And I think what I'm going to try and do is upload more videos during the week and have them less polished, I think. You know, I upload a video which, you know, to the best of my abilities, I just self-taught myself how to use the camera and the editing software to try and create like this really good video. The different cut scenes and the music that everybody loves. Really at the core, just trying to document my journey. And I feel like the way I've been producing the videos, a lot of little things get missed, which I believe add up to be super important. You know, things that form part of the journey. And I know that there's questions that you guys ask that, you know, I have done it and I would have showed it on camera, but it didn't fit. It didn't fit with what I was doing. So I'm going to try and be more consistent. I know the last time I said I was going to try and upload one video a week, I like didn't upload for 12 months, but I feel like this way is more honest way of documenting, and I think it creates a better connection. Let me know what you guys think. Thank you for watching this video. Feel free to leave a comment down below. Hit that subscribe button and that notification button. And till next time, see you later.